power goes before them all day long. What's with them at night? A pillar of fire. Should not they look and see God there? But all of a sudden, it's food, it's water, it's I'm tired, we're running around in circles. All the other people, they have gods that they can touch and see. God's, there was a problem. But they didn't realize that while there was an ever-present problem, while there was an ever-present evil, that there was an ever-present God. Sometimes we fail to see God. We fail to get in the Word. We fail to get in a place of prayer. We fail to just bask in His presence and look where God is. Because we cannot trace the hand of God, then we fail to trust Him. God is not looking to be traced tonight. God is looking to be trusted. Because He's faithful. And He's ever presently there with us. In the book of Hebrews, He reminds us that He was grieved with that generation, and they do err in their heart. They do not have their ways, so they could not enter in because of unbelief. I wonder tonight how much we don't get to enter into because we err in our heart. We allow unbelief to be there. When God says, I'm there. I'm there consistently. And though there's ever-present evil, ever-present problems, beginning to focus on an ever-present God. Tonight, I don't know where you are, what you may be going through, but God's faithful. And He's ever-present with us. I want to read one more passage of Scripture. I like what Psalms 33 says. I'm just going to start at the top. Rejoice in the Lord, O ye righteous, for praise is comely for the upright. Praise the Lord with harp, sing unto Him with psaltery and instrument with 10 strings. Sing unto Him a new song, play skillfully with a loud voice. For the word of the Lord is right, all His works are done in truth. He loveth righteousness and judgment. The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord. By the word of the Lord were the heavens made, and all the host of them by the breath of His mouth. He gathereth the waters of the sea together as a heap. He layeth up the deep in storehouses. Let all the earth fear the Lord. Let all the inhabitants of the world stand in awe of Him. For He spake, and as it was done, He commanded, and it stood fast. The Lord bringeth counsel of the heathen to naught, and maketh the devices of the people of none effect. The Lord standeth forever the thoughts of His heart to all generations. We read of the miraculousness of God, how He's worthy to be praised. And then the psalmist says this, that the counsel of the Lord standeth forever, the thoughts of His heart unto all generation. We read that He is a very present help in time of trouble. He is our refuge and our strength. To what generation? To every generation. Because they are the thoughts. See, I know things have changed. I look around and I see a world. I have to tell you, I'm disturbed. Y'all hear what's happening in Houston, Texas? The lesbian mayor asking for all the sermons to be handed in. Seeing what they said, they're trying to force any clergy now to perform same-sex marriages. Wow. I'm not sure of all logistics everywhere, but we're hearing it more and more. You know what? We're living in a wicked generation. More wicked than it's ever been before. But I need to tell you something. God's faithfulness is to every generation. God's thoughts are to every generation. Some folks may say, Pastor Bill, I feel like we are outnumbered. I don't. God's thoughts are still toward us. Amen. We don't need to fear. Amen. Though the mountains shake, amen, though the waters roar, amen, we don't have to be fearful tonight. The enemy is raging. He's working overtime. He knows the end is soon. Don't allow his working to discourage you. Have made up in your mind now more than ever before. We may face it. We may face it very soon. Allow fear to come out and confidence to be placed in a God who is a very present help in time of trouble. He is our refuge and our strength. I'm done tonight. How about you? What some thoughts that you think about that? Ever-present evil, always problems, but focusing on an ever-present help in a God who's always there. Anyone tell me?
I just say in Romans 8, if God is for you, who can be against you?
Amen. 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 And that is the promises, Brother Eli, that we talked about in Peter, that are precious promises that we need to remind ourselves of.
I also think that if the enemy is not attacking you, then you're obviously not doing something right because he doesn't see you as a threat. I was going back to that verse in Luke chapter 22 where Jesus said that Peter is saying he desired to sit as weak, but I prayed for you. When you look at the life of Peter, yes, he denied Christ. Yes, the cock crowed. But on the day of Pentecost happened, he was the first one to be proactive. He was the first one to preach. Next chapter, he's the first one involved, proactive in one of the healings, just like that. Then you find him proactive right after that in the temple preaching. You find him proactive with Cornelius. You know, if the devil would have gotten the upper hand with him, you know, what it comes down to is the devil when he was a threat.
Mm-hmm.
And I think as long if we don't have the devil fighting against us, then we're doing something wrong because he's not doing us as a threat. And even if we do get to that point where we do feel getting discouraged and stuff, I think we need to look to, I think it was Elijah or Elisha when they were on the mountain. I think it was Elijah. And Ahab was coming with his armies. And he prayed, God opened the eyes of the servant. And he's seen a thousand chariots. Yeah. God's right there with you, but if the enemy's not fighting against you, you're not doing something right.
Amen. And you're right. We need to see that spiritual battle that God is right there. We need to be aware of the enemy, and I'm not here tonight to give the enemy any glory. I'm here tonight to say, we need to be aware of his tactics. He is evil. That's why we face what we face. But God is never present to take away all fear. Very good. Someone else tonight? Saying that, we can go anywhere. Be confident in who God is. Be confident in the promises of God. Be confident in the holiness of God. I'm not hiding my face from anybody. I'm not walking around with a chip on. shoulder, but I know whose I am. And I think we need to know who we are. Because we need to live a life without fear of knowing that God is our present help in time of trouble. Did you ever go, I don't know if you've ever experienced this before, but I'm not a big person of height. I'm not. I don't like to be like really up high. My knees just kind of feel like jelly. Like, you know, I don't know if you all feel that or I'm just crazy in my mind, but that's just how it is. But, you know, if you're standing on the cliff and at the edge, we don't have to have the jelly feeling. We can behold majesty of God. Because God is a great help to help us. I love that. I love that. Don't just think about it and think, oh, I have it. Amen. Know that you know that you know. Because even though we hear it redundantly time and time again, there can still be an adequacy to fully experience this health and the strength and the presence of God. We've got to know that He is amazing. God is not weakened when problems come. God is not weakened by the attack of the enemy. God is still faithful. And we've got to know that He's in our midst. He doesn't want us living in a land of uncertainty. Amen. I don't want to err in our way. I don't want to enter in promise of knowing who He is. Let's stand tonight for just a few moments. Would you bow your head? And would you just say, God, make it real to me tonight. Make it real to me tonight. I don't want to be inadequate, but I want to adequately know that You are faithful. You are present help in time of trouble. And I don't need to fear anything. Hallelujah, Jesus.